You know, I've noticed something. In the ever-evolving landscape that is online conservative shitlordery, there's a constant theme. Being a mass group of hive minds who think the same thoughts, use the same language, and make the same lame insults. They have zero concern for being unoriginal, 100% unoriginal. When I started in earnest here, making videos, just about exactly 2 years ago, it seemed like a more innocent time when all I faced were the same hilariously simple-minded taunts that I'd already faced in elementary school about my red hair and my freckles. I faced initially clowns trying to make fun of my name like Dollarless or Dolladouche or Douche-a-more. You know, real creative stuff. Along with that came some traditional insults like fat ass and liar. There were even racist and homophobic slurs thrown in there that don't even thematically apply. And then Donald Trump's idiocy crept in and infected basement-dwelling neckbeards and whiny entitled mama's boys all over the country, who banded together on 4chan and Reddit and traded their independence and individuality for groupthink, using weak, tired, and unoriginal insults like politically correct or liberal and feminist, like those are even insults, and demoncrat, and even leftist with a capital L. And for those who can handle the multi-word, multi-syllabic taunts, regressive leftist. Well, then the amazingly original thinkers hurled libtard and snowflake and cuck and shill and beta and soy boy. Globalist seems to always be a classic that appeared and reappeared, as was SJW, which I still see from time to time. And for the record, if standing tall and speaking loudly for justice, social or otherwise, is a problem, that says more about these soft-skulled, knock-kneed cowards than it does about me. Well, this week came a new one. I would call it original, except for every single one of these impediments to progress is taking something they were told online to call liberals, and they're using it. That is not originality. That is following orders. That is being a pawn, a drone, a witting or unwitting idiot. The new insult, NPC, or non-playable character, which is apparently a term borrowed from, brace yourselves, because it's going to be the least shocking thing you've heard all day. The term is borrowed from the world of video games. According to the New York Times, it refers to a character that is controlled by the computer rather than by a player. An NPC often advances the game's plot by saying scripted lines or assisting the playable characters in some way. NPC. A video game reference. Way to really live up to the stereotype, you sad little trolls. Listen, since I'm fond of the art of well-crafted insults, I appreciate someone who puts a little thought, a little creativity, and originality into the names they call me. I thought I'd take a moment to help you little emotionally growth-stunted projection artists in figuring out better ways to insult me. First, avoid all of the hair color BS. I mean, please. If it's something you said or heard said when you only had a single digit in your age, it's likely weak and frankly meaningless. Rather than these unoriginal names, why not spice it up a little? You know, a little flair. Call me a hairy, goofy-grinned meat popsicle. Or maybe say that I stand here almost assuredly naked from the waist down, wearing only a sport coat and a dress shirt, babbling like a half-witted lunatic. Or maybe something about how I move my hands when I talk, that I flail my hands around like a mindless marionette puppet. Maybe something about how it isn't distracting anybody from the Soros-sponsored Slobberfest. Look, dingus or dinguses, or is it dingai? That's a question. Anyway, I can't be expected to do all of the heavy lifting for you. You're going to have to do better, to be better at the name calling. So, thank you for coming. And this concludes my TED Talk.